Alright, so I have my Android radio in the car right here, and everything seems to be working. I've had it for a while. And I'm about to install the GPS on it. I should have done it when I installed the radio, but I didn't think I needed it. I still don't think I need it. But I'm going to pull the radio out because, see right here, it's not flush like this side. So I'm going to take it, I'm going to sand it down a little bit. And hopefully when I push it back in, it'll be nice and clean. But while the dashboard's out, I'm going to put the antenna in. And my idea is I'm going to run it straight up through here and then into my little plastic wire here. And then I'm just going to have it sitting on the dashboard right here. And hopefully it gets a signal. If it doesn't, I'm not going to do it because I don't want to run a wire outside my car. If I have this, you know, GPS right here, which works unbelievably well. So, and I would never use it because I like this. So, anyways, alright guys, we'll see how this works. Oh. Here's the back of the radio, guys. I'm gonna run through it real quick, alright? Here's all your videos and backup cameras and your subwatt, okay? On this right here is your wireless dongle right here. This comes included, okay? And then here's another USB port for I don't know whatever. There's your GPS port right here, which I'm about to hook up to this little thing right here, okay? And then you got your FM antenna right here. Make sure that you have the adapter that goes with your antenna because it ain't gonna work without it. Then you have your standard wire harness right here, okay? Okay, so I'm gonna hook everything up now. There's the back of the radio. Okay, here's the GPS antenna in my hand and it screws into right here. You guys see that? Okay. Alright guys, I just installed the GPS and turn the car on, so let's see if it works before I hook everything back up. I just stuck the GPS in the window right there for right now. Let's see. L'activité physique. Le Covid. Tu aimes ça? Tu n'as pas d'intérêt pour le sexe? Les hommes pensent que les féministes. Okay. Well, let's hope this works. Alright, let's just go hit the navigation button first. This is the stock navigation system that comes with it. I haven't used it yet though, so I don't have no idea. I was using that. Oh, I got some new emails.
95 minutes commercial free.
Now we do it.
Well, I mean, it seems to be working, I guess, because there I am, right? So it does work. Let's see if Google Maps works now, right? Yep, cool. Anyways, cool. Okay, so now you guys got navigation. Some people are asking about that. Someone also asking about the back of the wire harness. So there you guys go. Okay, here's the GPS antenna in my hand and it screws into right here. You guys see that? Okay. Here's a preview of Google Maps, guys. Just so you know what it looks like. You should be familiar with your phone, but Pandora's still playing in the background. You can see right there. I mean, it seems to be going pretty good so far. We're gonna pull in right here. And switch to the other map just to see what it looks like. Look at that guy. That's cool. We don't want Google Maps anymore, so we're just going to keep kicking back like you would on your phone. All the way up. And click home. Okay, just so you guys know what I got going on up here. I got some emails. I got my little Jason Aldean station going on right now. If you don't like it, hit next. See, I got Wi-Fi on right now, which is being tethered to this phone right here. I can show you. If you go look right here, because I got one thing connected. I'll show you that real quick. Portable hotspot and my Android radio right there. I just normally leave it sitting right here. Anyways, okay, so we're gonna click home because we want to click the navigation button. Let's see what this is all about. I go. And I'm also going to go ahead and turn this on too, because this is the one I'm still going to use. It's 10 times better than both of the other ones. So there I am right there. See how quick that just turned on? Okay, so here we are right here. Not bad. I don't know if this didn't work earlier, but let's see if this works again. That it worked. That worked. That didn't work, which was supposed to be very cool, and then your favorites in history. But let's just try it again. Let's type in Hungry Howie's. Because I know there's one right down the road, that's why. And that's what it just said last time. It just kept saying search in progress. So I'm going to go on the iGo website, and I'm also going to email the guys. I'll let you know what's going on with that. But it's supposed to be powered by Google. That would have been cool to really work. So that's taking way too long for me, even if it's going to work, but I think it'll time out in a little bit. Let me click back out of that. But let's go find places right here. Let's see if this works. Around here, Hungry Howie's. This is 100 results. And the one in Wildwood, see? So it's got just as many points of interest as that one. Okay. So let's type in Hungry Howie's and see what it does. So I guess that little circle sign, there it is. There's the address. Let's see if it's got a phone number for it. Yes, it does. Very cool. Let's click go. There's a little preview. It's going to take 18 minutes to get there, 6.3 miles. Let's go. I don't know what I just did. What did I thought I clicked go. Okay, anyways. There it is. So I'm going to pull out and do whatever, but I'm going to go home, so let's just see if it keeps rerouting us. So, anyways, let me cancel that before I go home, just so you guys can see what a normal map would look like. See, okay, see this black button's not working, but the menu button's right here. My route, you want to cancel the route, we want to cancel the route. Now you want to go back, you want to show the map. That's what it looks like normally. Not too pretty. Now this is what I want you to notice right here, is that you get one, this is the road we're on, Penny Camp. You got Delwood, Edgewood, blah blah blah, okay? And then you got these other roads right here, okay? Now let's go look at this GPS. It's got the name of every road, which is very important for me when I'm driving around. Not only do I like to know what roads are by me, I don't want to just see a squiggly line over here and say, oh, I don't know what that road is. Maybe if I click it, it'll show me. I guess not. Okay. See, so that's very frustrating. So what if I click more? Places around the cursor. So it shows you, you know, names, I guess, but that's not. I've never heard of any of those, so that's really useless. I'm trying to see if I can go into menu and maybe turn up you know, the stuff on the map, how much detail it can show me. Map settings, maybe? Automatic. Map view mode, 3D. Viewpoint normal. Oh, that's cool. I want mine on high. Automatic overview on. Night map. 3D vehicle gallery. I guess I can change my vehicle. Oh, that's cool. So there's some cool features. Maybe they got like a red Jeep or something. Not a red car. That'll work for me. Okay, now if I click back, it should save it, I'm assuming. Okay, there we are. There's my little Jeep now. But I want more stuff on my map. I mean, I'll go through that later. But if I can't turn on more roads, I'm not going to be happy with this at all. What about... Oh, there's the night skin. Day skin thing. Well, not cool, man. I don't want to see three or four streets. I want to see all the streets. Well, I guess you can't. If not, I stand corrected. Not, I'll let you guys know. But what I'm talking about, just one more time, is here's this map. It just shows you a few streets. But look, there's all these streets right here that you don't know. Now on this one, every street is lined out. And I click this. Where do I want to drive to? I drive to home. And it just says, go. You know what I mean? So it's not hard here. And then there's my red line. That's sick. I would never trade that in for that right there. Okay? It's cool to have. My radio has it. But if you can put that right there and leave your radio right there so you guys can just... Like what I do is I leave mine on Pandora. And then there we go. I also don't have any interruptions from, you know, key buttons or phone calls or any of that crap. So, just so you know, your GPS is still running in the background if you see that. So you're going to want to scroll down, you're going to want to click the GPS, and I think you just clicking back, or the menu and then back, oh, power button right here, perfect. So that's the GPS.